For more than a century, mobility has been the beating heart of human progress, connecting us across vast distances, expanding our reach, and shaping our daily lives. But today, we stand at a crossroads like never before. With advancements in electrification, alternative fuels, and sustainable practices, the industry is undergoing a profound transformation. Even the most fundamental building blocks of the car, which have largely remained unchanged for decades, are now being reinvented, unlocking the future of mobility and driving us towards a world of limitless possibilities. I'm Asima Walsh, and this is Driven by Simulation. Our journey begins in Munich, where one company is rethinking the very essence of the automobile, the structure and the placement of the powertrain, through groundbreaking in-wheel drive technology.
So I'm Alex, co-founder and system engineer at DeepDrive. At DeepDrive, I'm responsible for all simulation-related topics like the efficiency of our electric machines, the power consumption of the vehicles, and yeah, all design topics related to simulation at DeepDrive. Before starting DeepDrive, I was responsible for the design of electric machines in large-scale series production, and I realized how important the topic of efficiency still is for electric vehicles. For example, looking at today's electric vehicles, we see that more than 40% of the energy, of the electrical energy, when looking from plug, so from the charging unit to the wheel, is still wasted. This is mostly because of the still quite inefficient powertrain. So in the powertrain, we lose up to 25% of the electric energy from battery to the wheel. This leads to a reduction of range. If you want to have an electric car today, it has a range of 500 kilometers. The powertrain would be ideal, so there would be no losses in the powertrain. The range would be almost 650 kilometers. There is a large gap, and we try to close this gap with efficient motor technology. When it comes to hardware startups, and especially in hardware startups, simulation is really one of the most important parts, especially in the early stage of a startup. I would even say it's impossible to start up a business like this without simulation. So using our motors as an in-wheel motor is really a fundamental change of vehicle architecture. You get rid of the central drive unit and you place the motor in the wheels. This gives you, because of the loss of transmission, the reduction of gearbox losses, a range advantage of 20%. It saves a lot of space in the vehicle. It makes the vehicle much cheaper. It allows realization of completely new vehicle concepts. Think of autonomous driven vehicles. Think of people carrier, people mover. All those concepts are enabled by our in-wheel motor technology. You see really a fundamental change of the design of electric vehicles. When talking about future mobility, it's really important to be more sustainable, to be more efficient, to reduce energy consumption of vehicles. And the deep drive motor technology, and especially when going into the wheels with our in-wheel technology, makes a significant contribution to that. 20% efficiency gain for all electric vehicles means a significant reduction of energy consumption of the world, of CO2 emissions in the power plants, and reduces the needed capacity of renewable energies all around the world.
In the vibrant tapestry of India, where transportation is a lifeline, Ashok Leyland has been a steadfast partner in the nation's journey towards progress. This iconic company, with a history dating back to independence, is rewriting a chapter on transportation with an innovative modular development platform, unlocking literally millions of sustainable build configurations, powertrains, and fuel possibilities.
If you look at every OEM in India, they have a partner, whether it is a technology partner or a financial partner. In our case, we are one of the few OEMs who are independent, which forces you to think differently, right? I mean, if you have to be independent, you have to survive in a market where there are a lot of technology coming from outside. So for us, that is the motivating force for us to be innovative, for us to sort of drive the technology forward. If you have kids, you'll know what model platform is. You know Lego sets. If you look at Lego sets, they're building blocks. And if you're Lego sets, you have certain interfaces. You look at the way you can put Lego sets together, it is very easy, intuitive. You can take simple building blocks, Lego blocks, and build complex structures, complex maybe trucks, maybe buses, maybe even robots and so on. But the basic fundamental is it's a bunch of pieces of play with a common interface. Think of it in a vehicle. If you can split the vehicle into building blocks, you can pull multiple combinations together. So that building block, the key enabler for us to do modularity, is to have good simulation tools.
Perhaps a reflection of the spirit of a rising India, Ashok Leyland's relentless commitment to building robust and sustainable vehicles is poised to drive economies and open up new possibilities.
So, you know, today we are number two in the country. We have a vast requirements for new products. There are many applications that are coming up. As the economy is growing, we have new road construction methodologies. We have new chemicals to be moved, new haulage products to be moved. We have Amazons and Flipkarts running light volume goods. So there are so many applications that are coming up. So we cannot have one standard menu for all. We have to have exclusive products, which means we have to test many products. It consumes a lot of time. We will not be able to launch as scheduled. Also, if we miss validating any of them, we end up compromising on the product quality. So only way to compress this is to do more virtual work, do simulations, cover everything before you physically build the product, and only validate physically those requirements which are very critical. Virtual simulation becomes essential part of our requirements to compress time, reduce cost, and go quick to market. So the challenge is handled well by doing more simulations and doing very limited tests that just confirms what we have done the simulation.
You see, one of the big advantages of modularity is you get a lot of variants quickly and fast. And in our case, we literally have 6 million variants. Now, how do you validate it? No, and also you think about Indian conditions. It's kind of some places getting overload, you know, some places it's off-road conditions. And how do you validate it? You can't go about testing the 6 million variants on the roads or on our tracks. It's very difficult. It's too costly as well. Simulation has become a part of life, and without simulation, we will not be able to really come out with big platforms and all. And we have more than a decades of relationship with Ansys as well. So it's kind of a settled down platform here.
Did you catch that? Over 6 million possible combinations. This is what digital transformation looks like. In order to get the products to market faster, companies like Ashok Leyland need the flexibility to evolve at the pace of technology. One of the ways to achieve that level is flexibility in digital engineering. You see, by using models to represent complex systems, in this case, systems like powertrains or passenger cabins, engineers can focus on the project requirements and connect their tools and simulation results where it's necessary to test and validate. This is how we can make the jump from testing only a handful of variations to literally millions in a short time and still maintain confidence throughout the design. Yet this voyage is far from over. We'll conclude our story back in Germany with a glimpse into the future of automotive technology. ZF is a global technology leader at the forefront of electrification, autonomous driving, and sustainable transportation solutions.
So we here at ZF are working on the next generation of mobility. We are in the domain of electrical drives, motors, and inverters. Yeah, we're developing in the e-drive systems. We also develop components, electrical motors, inverters, reducer unit, the gearbox itself. And from our expertise standpoint, we are able to bring this component together to a very complex system, which is absolutely integrated. And this kind of approach we are using there, or gives us the possibility to make it not just a solution of different components and parts. It is a fully integrated, efficient, summed up solution for the e-drive mobility sector.
We are using simulation from the beginning on, starting with the component level, subsystem level, to prove out whether systems are fulfilling requirements in terms of durability and everything, going to the next level to see what is happening if software is integrated. Is the product still doing what it is supposed to do? And that is mainly based on the simulation level. We are collaborating in many areas with Ansys because Ansys is one of our main tools for simulation and functional safety. And the teams are really, really collaborating directly with Ansys and solving the problems in terms of getting support, in terms of special physical problems, and also in automation and process optimization and stuff like that. I think that ZF is an also top level of simulation capabilities. And digitalization is a wide definition. We have a clear understanding that we need simulation to have a kind of a pre-release virtually to go into hardware. Without a certain level of maturity of the simulation result, we don't go into hardware with a big risk to fail.
So in the field of e-drive technologies, we have to tackle with a lot of different domains, physical aspects. To address these different problems, we use simulation to catch the physics, electromagnetic behavior, thermal behavior, mechanical strengths and stresses, and all together are necessary to tackle such a complex task and problem. With simulation, we are capable to make physical effects visible. For example, electromagnetic fields. We can see where areas of high saturation, for example, occurs. We can model the components with respect to its physical limitations. We can go to the boundary, and therefore we need simulation.
From ingenious in-wheel electric motors to innovative modular design capabilities, our peek into the future of mobility proves that innovation knows no bounds, and the road ahead is paved with limitless possibilities. Join me next time as we take you off the beaten path and discover how simulation permeates even the most uncharted territories. I'm Miss Emma Walsh, and this is Driven by Simulation.